the meat just pulled out. What up? Coming to you live from the wheels of NYC car meet. So I think I'm gonna start going to car meets more like this, because this is more of a VIP meet. Like, I like to go to normal car meets and just chop it up with some people, but I think this is more of my style, and I feel like you guys, the viewers, enjoy these type of car meets more than just your traditional like parking lot meet. But let's walk around and check out some cool cars. There's definitely some things I've never seen before. A lot of Euros, to be honest. I think my Honda Life, I wouldn't say doesn't belong here, but because I have the Motocampo, I think that's why I was allowed. Because to come into here, you have to send some pictures. They have to like approve you. You got to come at a certain time. And when we walk around this lot, you're going to see, the Honda Life, to be honest, maybe doesn't fit the mold of what they're trying to promote. But it is Wheels of NYC, so there's a little bit of everything here. But we got a sick M3. I think there's a Lego up here as well. Alcantara wheel. Wow, this thing is completely done up. Got the Insta 360 back there. 89 M3. Wow, Canada plate. This is sick. Nice BMW wagon. I think this is a... is this a 7 or an 8? I feel like I've seen this car before. Oh, 6. Wow, 635. So that's cool. I think this is an 8, right? This has to be an 8. Yeah, it's an 850. I like this car a lot because it has pop-ups. Really nice. Another M3. More on the stockish side. But yeah, I'm gonna walk around outside and inside because there's some cool cars over here. There's some cool cars over there. You can see the Pajero. The right-hand drive RAV4, whack-ass Miata. No offense. If you're watching this video, guy, it's not really whack. I'm traumatized. But this guy's cool. This is a British Racing Green Edition. So you get like the Nardi shifter. You get the Nardi e-brake, Nardi wheel. All this is stock. Speakers in the headrest, which is nice. A lot of people, and you get the BBSs, but a lot of people love these Miatas. I just don't care about them anymore. Let's check out this Beetle, actually. I was gonna save the outside section separately, but what the hell? Is this comfortable to sit in though? Those beats? I feel like that'd not be a comfortable ride. This thing is sick. M5. Nice Evo. Get back into the Porsches. This blue one is definitely in my top 5 cars here. My cousin has a Porsche, but this color and the fact that it's so stock in the interior is really nice. Wow, it says turbo on the seats, on behind the seats. That's amazing attention to detail. Drop top Porsche right here. This old guy is cool too. This is a 912. I like that. I like this white one too with the roof rack. This guy is super clean. Like the plate. Is that a Vandy plate or is that a real plate? Hold on. That's a real plate? That's crazy. Oh, wow. Attention to detail. It's beautiful. All these Porsches got vanity plates. Is that a Porsche thing? I know the Porsche community is a little. That's all I gotta say. I've heard about you guys. Oh, look. Red. Dial. Weird plate. Hold on. Let's go back. This guy has a vanity plate too, then I'm convinced that, oh wow. Wow. Look. Hey, oh, this guy. Well, this guy doesn't have one, but 82 Targa. This guy doesn't have a vanity plate, neither does he. All right, so this little row of people don't, but the other 5 Porsches do. Over here, we have this Volkswagen. I don't know what country. Looks like a Jetta or something, but it's lifted. It's a Golf. Wow, it's a lifted Golf country. And it's a convertible, what? And it's manual, what again? This thing is sick. We got, last time I was at Dunkin', everybody was like, I didn't show this car enough love, but I see them often. They are very iconic, they are very legendary. I know the history about it. I know how this won so many races and they had to make like a road version and it was this. This one is mint. Yeah, that car's cool. Definitely want to get one of those one day. nice range, another Volkswagen. Hopefully you guys can hear me over the music. I'm trying to my best. I should have started this video when there wasn't as many cars here, but I wanted to get full. This is an S2P. This is nice. It's yellow. Gated shifter, lamb. This Volvo, I think, is definitely in my top, not even think, this Volvo's in my top five, 100%. I don't know anything about it. Someone comment below, but I just knew by the color that it was special. And then look at the interior color, and I was like, oh yeah, this thing is sick. It's automatic, I believe. But this car is sick. It's an R. I know they made a cool R. I guess this is what it is. I see R in certain places too, but yeah, this thing is sick. S2K on some TEs. So clean. I'm gonna be a Honda drop top boy real soon. You wait on it. Just you wait. Got a couple Benzes. This guy's huge. This is a turbo diesel 300 CT. Wow, this guy's cool. I saw him pull in. Nice drop top. Seen this car a couple times. Oof, that steering wheel though, no hate at all. Don't love that steering wheel though. Actually getting closer, it's a little cooler. And then we have this car, Kaki from Aruba. What is this? Lancia. Wow. Purple rain right here. Prince, where are you at? The all purple Chevy. This is cool. I like that he has newer headlights. Like, I get it, the whole purist thing, but he has Miata like LEDs. Like, this car is actually drivable at night. This is nice. I wonder, I feel like this isn't the original interior. I don't know if they were smart enough to put cup holders back then. I just feel like he maybe did that. This car is cool though. What else we got? The Silencia. I can always appreciate any two-seater, two-door car. Love the color. This car is definitely in my top five too. Love the white rims. Navy, yellow lights, German plate, bike on top. This Prado's really nice. This two-door G-Wagon though. You know how I always called my car the poor man's G-Wagon? This is really like, this really looks like a bigger version of the Jimny. That thing is nice. It's a clean car. This I have, I couldn't even tell you. A lot of times I say comment below what this is, but I need your help because this is a, I'm not even gonna try to pronounce that, but that's what this is. And for some reason, it's in Brooklyn. For some reason, this car is in Brooklyn. It is manual, has a sunroof, has a shower. I wonder, wow, it has a camera in the back. I wonder if it has seats. I can't really tell. It's too tinted. Oh no, it doesn't have seats. It has kind of nothing back there. But yeah, for some reason, this car made it from wherever its origins are to Brooklyn. It's pretty sick. This old school Caddy is beautiful. Literally the size of 2K cars. Old school Montana plate. Hopefully the camera really picks up how huge this car is. Like, look at that guy standing next to it. He could probably lay down. Maybe three times, or at least two and a half. This car is huge. It's probably like the biggest convertible top ever. Big body Caddy. This is the definition of a big body Caddy. Then we got a Cherry. What is this? 69 Impala. Another huge convertible top. My goodness. I feel like I could sleep under that top. This thing is nice. I love the attention to detail. Like, it's a little subtle, but I like it. I would do something like that and put like Wait for the Fame, where like you can only tell when you get like this close to it. Regardless, it just looks like some black lines. Then we have this. love seeing cars like this over here. Like I said, like that weird thing being in Brooklyn, this being in Brooklyn. This guy's clean. Love the color. Wow, he put modern stuff in there too. Look at that screen. Seats look new. This is a G-Wag from Illinois. Super cool. Like the color. Shout out to these guys playing music. Hopefully I don't get demonetized. Let's see what else is over here. I'll do that last row where my car is last. This thing is sick. I love that they're just picnicking back there. Don't want to invade their space, but it says Dart on the floor mat, so I believe that makes it a Dodge Dart. Something Dart. I think it's Dodge. Correct me if I'm wrong. Then we have this Buick. This is a 1987 Buick Grand National with 15,000 miles. All right. That's some low miles, my friend. Look at them though, chilling back there with those things. I forgot what they're called, but those are cool. And we have another Grand National. Boost gauge engine with some work. Then we have this. This is a Super B Dodge 383 Magnum. Very nice. Next to this drop top. I gotta get me one of these, man. Back on the Euro Beamer side, we got a wagon, 3 Series, I believe another 3 Series. So let's walk down this lane. Which way should I go? Should I come this way or that way? Actually, let's go outside and check out some of the cars in the parking lot. Show them some love. Just cause you couldn't get inside don't mean you're not gonna get some way before the fame, love. So we got a Vette, drop top Mazda. Love this Forester. Everybody's getting vanity plates now. If I get my Honda Beat, I'm gonna put my license plate as B-E-E-T, as in like beat. Oh, look at this guy. Look at this guy. He said, what do I need a parking? Oh, there's somebody in the car. I was gonna say, damn, he's gangster. Still gangster though, but I thought he just left it like that. That's some real New York gangster shit. Some more cars over here. You about to leave?
Yeah, I'm gonna leave
too. You leave? Oh. Yeah. Hey, what's up?
Just some... waiting for Ken.
Oh, okay. Yeah, some cool cars out here, like I said. Ooh, this is nice. This right-hand drive? Oh, it is right-hand drive. More Mazdas pulling up. Love those wheels. I actually had a set of these, but they weren't chrome. Then we got this guy. Fuel injected. Deck van vibes, automatic, front bash bar, kind of looks like a midget. Thing is sick. One of the best cars here. Got a 7 Series, this R32 is nice. Another BMW. Oh, I think it's funny he has his laptop there. That's jokes. A lot of attention to detail that's here. I think that's why I like this meet in comparison to like your parking lot ones. Because like having a bat here, I think is cool. Being able to just have your windows down, having a laptop there for like, you know, some chuckles is funny. And then that Subaru has a really nice setup too, but we'll get one of those eventually. MR2, I love. Told you guys over and over, I will be getting a second gen MR2. Got the T-tops out. But I will be getting a second gen MR2 eventually. This TRV is nice. Right-hand drive. I believe this is a European car. I love that it has this foldable thing. It's kind of like a roaster almost. It's giving cappuccino vibes where like you can put that up, you can put that down. That's pretty sick. Then we got this Corolla, gutted, Recaros. Love that window. Very nice. But look at this guy. Talk about attention to detail. I don't even know how this is on right now. But this is a video of the Subaru, and that's exactly what this car is. Then we have this Nas bottle that I'm assuming is not connected. We got some, you know, some classic JDM movies and magazines. And then here's the car. Auntie's clean, big spoiler. definitely one of my top five cars here. This Jaguar is always cool. It's some guy, where is he? But yeah, whenever I see this car, I'm just like, wow, it's sick. Cappuccino. I wanted this to be my next K car, but I think that the B's gonna happen first, and then maybe we'll get the cab next. Cool car though. Love the rims. He got this from Dunkin' actually. I know he paid a pretty penny, but it is a very clean car, so if you got it, you got it. Me, on the other hand, I gotta buy some ugly stuff so I could then put some money into it slowly. Two cars that we see very often. Look at the homie taking pictures of the Moto Compo. Sarah's gonna happen eventually soon too. I know I'm saying like I'm gonna buy 90 cars soon, but if you haven't already, join the Honda Life Waffle. I'll tell you guys how many slots we're at right now on the screen. It's actually moving very quickly. It's only been like, not even just like 7 hours. I posted it last night. Then we got this Volkswagen. This thing is cool. This is a K car if I'm not mistaken. He had the hood popped earlier and it looked like it was only a 3-cylinder. It can't be a K car though, right? Yeah, it can't be a K car. This is cool though. I think it's a 1.1 liter, but it was a 3-cylinder for sure. But I like this, I like the roof rack. This guy's clean. And then lastly, we have, I think it's called a Yugo. I remember looking at this car last year. Yeah, Yugo. These things are so nice. I feel like somebody was commenting under my videos though, saying that this company went out of business after a couple years, but the fact that there's still one here that's preserved and the interior is beautiful. Nice little like caramel color. But all right, I'm in this video here. Cool meet, met a lot of people. I'm gonna do some networking. I'm gonna pull the Moto Compo out next.